Welcome everybody for this meeting. Facebook. Google.
So yeah, generative AI.
It's all right. Listen, calm down. The reason I've called this meeting is because we have to do something or the other about this NVIDIA. He's worth more than you, Facebook. He's worth more than me. What if tomorrow he's worth more than Google?
Generative AI.
Or Apple. What are you guys gonna do then? We have to stop him. We have to stop.
Stop whom exactly?
Hey, NVIDIA. NVIDIA. What are you doing here? This is our office.
This is not your office anymore. This is my office.
What? Facebook, tell him. Google, say something.
Generative AI.
Wait. Why aren't you guys saying anything? You guys want to kick me out? What? No!
NVIDIA is now worth more than Facebook, Tesla, and Netflix. According to Reuters, the stock's value has tripled in the last 8 months. But how did this happen? How did a company that was almost on the verge of bankruptcy in 1997 hit a $1 trillion market cap in 2023? Let's find out by understanding what NVIDIA actually does. And for that, we'll have to go back to school and revise, starting with how do the parts of a computer work? The major parts of the computer are input devices like your keyboard and mouse, output devices like your monitor and speaker, storage, where the computer stores information like your hard disks and external hard drives, and CPU, which is the central processing unit. I want to stop here and show you what an actual CPU looks like. You see, in my school textbooks, they showed us a picture of a random PC case and called it a CPU. But that's not a CPU. The entire thing is called a cabinet or a chassis. This device is called a CPU. This tiny chip is where the processing and calculations in the computer happen. Some examples of these are Intel's i7 or AMD's Ryzen processors. And finally, we come to the piece of hardware every gamer, video editor, and crypto miner, and now AI startup is after, which is the GPU, the graphic processing unit. When a computer needs to display complex visuals, like in video games or 3D modeling, the GPU takes over and renders these images. And do you know who coined the term GPU? It was none other than NVIDIA. Today, NVIDIA is almost at a $1 trillion market cap because of these GPUs. But they didn't reach this milestone overnight. Now, I have read the NVIDIA annual earnings report, but before we get into the business side of things, I want to tell you the story of NVIDIA, with four major events or turning points that made NVIDIA what they are today. NVIDIA was founded in 1993 by Jensen Huang, Chris Malachowski, and Curtis Prehm, three engineers who believed that graphics-based computing could end up being the future. The first turning point for NVIDIA was in 1997 when they almost went broke. NVIDIA was working on graphics hardware for Sega's gaming console. For all of you Gen Zs, Sega is a company much like Nintendo that was competing in the console market back in the day. They were the first ones to launch the Sonic series, and NVIDIA was building a graphic card for Sega's 128-bit console, Dreamcast. But 1 year into development, NVIDIA realized that they had taken the wrong approach because Microsoft was about to announce their own texture mapping approach, which would make NVIDIA's product incompatible with Windows 95. Imagine you worked all this while for something and the platform you're building it for decides to change path. You are now stuck. So if NVIDIA continued to build this console, it would be an inferior product and incompatible with Windows. So not many will buy it and they'll eventually go broke. But if they didn't build it, they would instantly go broke. Those were the choices for NVIDIA: go broke later or go broke now. So Jensen Huang, CEO of NVIDIA, gets on a phone call with the CEO of Sega and tells him that NVIDIA won't be able to build this graphic hardware for their console and that they should find another partner. Then he makes a humbling ask. Some would call it embarrassing as well. He asked the CEO of Sega to pay him in full, because without that money, NVIDIA would die. It's almost like straight up asking for money, because NVIDIA hadn't delivered what they promised to Sega. And surprisingly, Sega paid them. Jensen Huang to this day doesn't know why they did that, but this gave them enough money to sustain for another 6 months. During this, NVIDIA built their next graphic card, Riva 128, which put NVIDIA back on the map.
Hi, so last year we started a video mastery cohort
with the goal in mind that we wanted to create impact in the lives of the people who watched us. We have done 3 cohorts up to now, and we're going to be starting 4th one. And we've trained up to 800 students and created impact on each of these lives. We have students who have started working with international creators like Ali Abdal and getting paid up to 30 LPA. We have even more students who are working with creators like Tanmay Bhatt, Finance with Charan, and huge billion-dollar companies like Un Academy. In fact, we have students who have started their own creator journey, started pulling 500,000 views. We have business owners who decided to start their content creation journey and do 100K views on long form and expand their already existing business. In fact, we're so proud to announce that all of these guys that work in AV are our students from the cohort. So if you're a student, a full-time employee, or a business owner who wants to embark on the journey of content creation, we have a free class that's happening on July 5th. You can register for the class by clicking the link in the description. We're going to be teaching you all the fundamentals of YouTube, from scripting, video production, editing, and everything in between. See you there, and back to the video.
The second turning point. Over the next few years, NVIDIA started to see some growth, but manufacturing these chips was getting expensive. NVIDIA entered a manufacturing contract with TSMC. NVIDIA wanted to be a fabless company. They didn't want to make the chips themselves because manufacturing in the US is a low margin business. Today, TSMC makes chips for Apple, AMD, NVIDIA, and many other tech companies. This is a partnership NVIDIA heavily relies on, but this partnership has gotten complicated. Why? You'll have to wait till the end of the video for that particular reveal. Back to 2000s. NVIDIA won a contract to make graphics hardware for Microsoft's Xbox, which gave them $200 million in advance. Next year, they hit $1 billion in revenue and were the driving force behind many video games that came out that year. The next turning point was important for 2 reasons. One is that the games that were specifically optimized for NVIDIA cards started to become the popular ones. Second, NVIDIA wasn't just good at making graphic cards anymore, they were collaborating with game developers themselves. The point is, they were not just making graphic cards, they were also helping developers like Blizzard optimize games for NVIDIA hardware to make sure that the frame rate is smooth, the gaming experience is great. They still do it today. In fact, DLSS, one of their upscaling technologies, was implemented recently and has been adopted by many game developers. Back then, they called it the way it's meant to be played program. This has become very common today. That's why you see powered by NVIDIA or preferred partner NVIDIA in the opening screen of so many games. And all these games are optimizing their games specifically to NVIDIA graphic cards. Soon, NVIDIA's GeForce was used by PS3s as well. They were selling graphics hardware for both Xbox and PlayStation. They had become the person that sells shovels to the people in a gold rush. Today, when gamers debate who will win between Xbox and PlayStation, the answer is NVIDIA, because their chips are in both of them. This brings us to the next turning point. The reason NVIDIA is needed today is for AI companies. In the last few years, it was crypto companies, now it's AI companies. No matter what trend comes out, as long as the computing-based trend, NVIDIA will win. They released something called CUDA, or Compute Unified Device Architecture, a technology that I spend a lot of my time working on the technical side of things. It specializes in parallel processing. Now I'm going to get slightly technical, but bear with me so that we can understand it properly. Usually CPUs are good at serial processing, and NVIDIA's CUDA-powered GPUs are great at parallel processing. CPUs can have maybe 8 or 16 cores, but a GPU has many, many more cores. So while GPUs tend to take single tasks, finish it, and move to the next tasks, the GPUs, on the other hand, can break down a task. For example, if you're rendering a scene, the GPU can render different parts of the scene on different cores. For example, when we put Thanos in one of our videos, the rendering of Thanos was done on the RTX 4090, and if you look at the rendering process, each part of the scene was rendered separately from the other. It was happening in parallel. At the end of the day, what's happening behind the scenes is simple mathematical calculations, which is the same whether you're doing AI or you're doing, let's say, a 3D rendering. Now, NVIDIA had already established itself in the gaming market, but by 2012, NVIDIA wasn't just powering graphic cards. They had new use cases: data centers, GPUs in the cloud, and of course, training AI models. Turns out the same method of parallel processing, which was useful for rendering graphics, was ideal for deep learning, where the computer learns the underlying patterns based on inputs and outputs. NVIDIA recognized that this could change the world of computers forever, so they started focusing heavily in making chips specifically to train AI. They called this their deep learning division. Now, the finance guys at Wall Street were confused about this and valued their deep learning division at $0 for 10 years. And you know what else parallel processing is good for? Crypto mining. The crypto mining process involves solving complex mathematical problems that require a lot of compute power. So GPUs with good parallel processing became a must in the crypto gold rush as well. People filled up their basements with these cards. That's why their market cap also went up in 2021. The same thing is happening again with the AI gold rush. Companies like OpenAI, Amazon, and Facebook are filling entire buildings with GPUs to train AI models like GPT and Llama. But these aren't exactly the same GPUs we use for gaming. NVIDIA has been building separate GPUs like this A100, which is optimized for deep learning and costs more than $10,000. ChatGPT, for example, was trained on 10,000 of them, which would have costed a lot of money. ByteDance, the parent company of TikTok, ended up spending $1 billion as recently as a week ago acquiring chips from NVIDIA. And that's probably the reason why Sam Altman thinks that Indian startups won't be able to compete with OpenAI with just $10 million in funding. It's hard, it requires a lot of money. Just like with the console wars, regardless of who wins the AI race, NVIDIA is already winning because most of these companies are using NVIDIA's GPUs to train their model. So now that we know the full story of NVIDIA, how do they make money? They have five major markets, which is gaming, which is data centers, professional visualizations, which is 3D modeling software, VFX, studios like Red Chili's will be buying chips, automotives and OEMs. Here is the revenue of each of these departments. Visualizations, automotives and OEMs haven't changed drastically, but gaming has been their highest earner till Q4 of 2021. The increase also happened because of the crypto boom and therefore caused a GPU shortage, which also shot up prices. Even until quarter three of FY 2022, the gaming division still dominated. In 2023, the gaming revenue has fallen a bit and not many people are buying gaming GPUs or cards to mine cryptos. But NVIDIA is not too worried about this because look at their data center revenue. It's growing all thanks to the AI boom. I keep seeing tweets on my timeline where people are buying clusters of GPUs just to make their own farm. Now let's look at where NVIDIA is spending their money. It spends almost $2 billion on research development. This is the advantage of being a fabless company. NVIDIA puts most of its effort into research to make the best GPUs in the world and very little into manufacturing. They've outsourced it to multiple players. One of these major players is TSMC. And this partnership is getting a bit complicated. TSMC is in Taiwan. Taiwan considers itself independent, but China claims Taiwan is a part of China. So China has been teasing Taiwan by flying jets into their airspace. And even relationships between US and China have not been great. And major companies want to shift their chip manufacturing units outside of China's control. The US President Joe Biden introduced the CHIPS Act, which roughly gives $280 billion in new funding to boost research and manufacturing of semiconductors in the US. TSMC is building two chip factories in Arizona, one of which is estimated to start production in 2024. But again, the problem with this is that if it's in the US, it is going to be expensive. And that's where countries like India might be able to help. India too has announced an incentive of $10 billion of semiconductor manufacturing. India is poised to become a major global hub in semiconductor manufacturing over the next 10 years if a lot of things go its way. At this moment, they seem to be one of the most valuable companies in the world and reach this place through humility, multiple innovations, and a lot of research. And on that note, if you like well-researched, entertaining videos, like this and subscribe to AevyTV for more such content.